Okay, so as I mentioned in the previous class that we can convert from one flip-flop to any other flip-flop according to these steps. Okay, so this is called the conversion of the flip-flops. Now, rather we go for the theory, if you just do one example, then that will be very much clear to you how to do the conversion from one type of flip-flop to the other type of the flip-flops. Suppose in this example, we need to convert one D type flip-flop into an JK flip-flop. Okay. So here from the question, convert an D type flip-flop into an JK flip-flop, which is the desired flip-flop?
JK, sir.
Very good. So it's a very clear that our expected flip-flop, final destination flip-flop, is the JK flip-flop. This is called the desired flip-flop. Okay, we want JK flip-flop. And which one is the given flip-flop?
D flip-flop.
D flip-flop. So any confusion with this word, given and desired flip-flop? I think no. Okay. So from the question, you need to understand which one is the given flip-flop, which one is the destination, not the destination of the desired flip-flop. Okay. So in this particular example, you need to implement a JK flip-flop using a D flip-flop. So first step one, just look the tooth table of the desired flip-flop. So here our desired flip-flop is the JK flip-flop. So you need to look into the JK flip-flop tooth table and specifically note Q to Q n plus 1 transition for a given combination of the input JK and present state Q. It means this one. Okay, so we'll come to this later. So step two, from the Qn to Qn plus transition, write the input combination of the desired flip-flop with the help of the excitation table of the given flip-flop. And last, from the state synthesis table, with the help of a K-map, write the design equation of the desired flip-flop, like this one. Here, what is our desired flip-flop?
JK, sir.
JK. So we need to look what table of the JK flip-flop? The tooth table.
Tooth table, yes.
So come to this one. So this total whole table is called the state synthesis table, because that table will give you the condition for this transition. Okay, means D to JK transition. So that's why it is called the state synthesis table. Now, first the tooth table of the desired flip-flop, that is the JK flip-flop. And as you know, the tooth table is nothing but the relation between input and output combination, where the input known, and from the equation we need to know the output value. So that's why in case of a JK flip-flop tooth table, the input is written first, J and K. Okay, so and Qn is also one of the input of the flip-flop, because this is a sequential logic circuit. So three variables are there, Jn, Kn and Qn. So how many possible combinations are there?
Eight different
combinations. So eight combinations are written here, from starting from 000 to 111. Okay. And you see how to fill up the Qn plus 1, it's from the tooth table. Means if both are 00, then it will follow the same state. That means whatever be the Qn value, the Qn plus 1 will reflect the same value. 00 again, 1 to 1, because the input J and K both are 00. So whatever be the past output Qn, the same as the Qn plus 1. If J equal to 0, K equal to 1, then it will always 0. If J equal to 0, K equal to 1, it is always 0. If J equal to 1 means these two particular row, J1, K0. So J1 means flip-flop will be set. And last, when both are 1, 1, it will toggle. Means if the past output was 0, next output will be 1. And if the past output was 1, next output will be 0. That is the toggling state. So that means you know how to write the JK flip-flop tooth table. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, what is the excitation table? Means in the excitation table, what do we read in the first? Like in the tooth table, we write the input first. And in case of excitation table, what do we write?
Qn and Qn plus 1.
Very good. We write the output transition first. Means Qn, past output, and the next output. So, here you see. This is the state synthesis table of the, sorry, this is not the state synthesis table. This is the excitation table of the given flip-flop. Excitation table of the given flip-flop means given flip-flop is the D flip-flop. So here you see Qn and Qn plus 1 is written first, but here the condition is like that 0, 0, then it is obviously 0, because whatever be the value of the Qn plus 1, the D will be reflect the same value. Opposite, obviously, whatever be the value of D, the Qn plus 1 reflect the same value. So the arrow should be like this one. Okay, in this way, you need to fill up this one. Now here you see, now we just combine these two tables. But here you see, J is Jn, Kn. Okay, then Qn and Qn plus 1 is there. And from this Qn and Qn plus 1, just add a column here, like this. Add a column here, write the D. Okay, like the D or Dn, whatever you say. Then you need to write the excitation table of the given flip-flop. So given flip-flop here is D. So you need to write the excitation table like this. So you need to add these two tables. So 0, 0 means what happened? So Qn equal to 0, Qn n plus 1 equal to 0. So what will be the value of D?
0, sir.
0. So whatever be the value of Qn plus 1, D will reflect the same value. Okay, that is the excitation table of the given flip-flop. Now we just combine, that's why I draw it separately. That is the excitation table of the D, that is the given excitation, the truth table of the desired flip-flop JK. Now we just combine the two tables and it's become like this. So here you see from the arrow, this arrow, from this arrow, this is actually the truth table of the desired flip-flop JK, and this is the excitation table of the given flip-flop, that is D. Now from these two table, you need to find out the expression of D using these three input J, where is the pointer, J, K and Qn. How? You need to write a K map, three variable K map, D equal to 1 here, and see the combination. Combination is J0, K0, Qn equal to 1. Similarly, D are 1 in these three rows, and just check the three combinations. In this way, you need to write the expression. You need to fill up the table for the truth table. You need to fill up the K-map cells and then need to group this thing and ultimately find the expression for D in terms of J, K and Qn. And this is the design equation, that is called the design equation, and that table is called the state synthesis table. Okay, not this one. This is actually the separate table. This is actually the just breaking of this table. This is the truth table, that is the excitation table. But if you just combine these two table, it becomes the state synthesis table of, sorry, for the D to JK flip-flop conversion. And from the state synthesis table, using the help of K-map, you need to find out the expression for the D, the given flip-flop input, and that is the conversion. After you do doing this one, just take one D flip-flop, and D input is what? D input is like this one. You need to implement that expression. So just take the two other input, J and K, and just implement this expression, J and Qn bar. So Qn bar is this one. This one is the Qn bar. So take this one and this two, and Kn bar Qn. So using this NOT gate, put the find the Kn bar and ended with Qn, and then ultimately add them two together to find out the expression for D. So if you do these things like this one, then you see D to JK flip-flop. So this is the same circuit. Okay, this one. So here you see, what is the flip-flop used here? What is the flip-flop used here?
D flip-flop.
D, sir.
That means the heart of the circuit is the D flip-flop. Okay, and but the whole circuit is working on the principle of JK flip-flop. So this is a JK flip-flop, but the JK flip-flop is implemented using a D flip-flop, because the heart of the circuit is only one flip-flop, which is the D flip-flop. So this is called the D to JK flip-flop conversion. We have a D flip-flop, but the D flip-flop is not working according to the principle of D flip-flop. It will operate according to the principle of JK flip-flop. How? Because we have done the state synthesis table, we have find out the expression for D, and we implement it like this one. Now let's see, J equal to 1, k equal to 0, we know that if so first we need to run the circuit. So we know that if j equal to 1, k equal to 0, flip flop will be set. So just give the clock pulse. The, here I, for the better understanding, I connect a manual clock pulse. So I give the clock pulse, and on the occurrence of the clock pulse, you see flip flop becomes set. Okay, according to the truth table of the JK flip flop. Now, if both are 0, 0, what will happen? J 0, K 0. What happen? What will happen?
Memory state, sir.
Key state?
না একই থাকবে স্যার আগেরটাই থাকবে
হ্যাঁ সেটাকে কি স্টেট বলে মেমরি স্টেট বলে না ইটস এ নো চেঞ্জ স্টেট
নো চেঞ্জ স্টেট
স্যার ওকে সো দ্যাট মিন্স দিস ইজ দা প্রিভিয়াস নাও আই গিভ দা ক্লক পালস কেয়ারফুলি অবজার্ভ আই গিভ দা ক্লক পালস নো চেঞ্জেস উইল বি देयर ওকে সো টু কলামস ইজ ভেরিফাইড নাও কে ইকুয়াল টু 1 জে ইকুয়াল টু 0 হোয়াট উইল বি দা আউটপুট এক্সপেক্টেড আউটপুট জে 0 কে 1 On the occurrence of the clock pulse, what will be the output?
Reset.
Reset. Very good. So reset means Q becomes 0, Q bar become 1. So see, I give the clock pulse, flip flop become reset. And when both are 1, 1, then what will happen?
So in return when?
What? When no, J no. equal to 1, K equal to 1?
Q bar 1, Q 0.
It will toggle. When J R K both are short circuited, the single input becomes the T. It's a toggle flip flop. So on the occurrence of the clock pulse, it will toggle from 0 to 1. If now it is 0, if the clock pulse will arrive, it become 1. Again, if the clock pulse arrive, it becomes 0. So it's a toggle between 0, 1, 0, 1 like this. As much as the clock pulse will present, it will toggle between 0, 1, 0, 1. So that means this circuit works as the truth table of the JK flip flop, but inside the circuit, the heart of the circuit, we used a D flip flop. So this is called the D to JK flip flop conversion. In the similar way, we can convert from one flip flop to any other flip flop according to our requirement. Okay. So in the same way, we can convert any other flip-flop from a given flip-flop, whatever be the given flip-flop. So any flip-flop can be converted with other flip-flop. Remember the steps. First, we need to write the truth table of the desired flip-flop. Then just add one column, which is the excitation table of the given flip-flop. Then find out the expression for the given flip-flop input with the help of the desired flip-flop inputs like this one. This is called the state synthesis table, and from the state synthesis table, with the help of KMF, find out the expression for D. Find out the expression for the given flip-flop input with the help of the desired flip-flop output and the Qn bar and the Qn past output. It will call the design equation. After finding out the design equation like this one, just draw the circuit. Okay. So practice any flip-flop conversion, or better, I will give you one suggestion for the semester, that already you have the question bank here. The so many year questions are there. Just look at the question, and I hope that every question you are able to answer except the register and the counter, because these two key things are not covered yet. So except the registers and counter, whatever be the other questions are there, I think you are habituated with this one. And if you have a good practice, then you can easily do this thing. If you not understand any question coming to any year in the semester, just take a picture of this question and send me. I will help you definitely. But I hope from the notes, you can, if you follow the notes properly, if you attend the class properly, then you can easily do the question came in the previous year's semester up to the flip-flop. Now come to this one, the next topic, which is called the register. Now, what is the register? So register is nothing but a group of the flip-flop or the arrays of the flip-flop. Okay. Now, as I mentioned that the flip-flop is the basic building blocks of the memory element. Now just give me one example of the memory element. Just give me one example of the memory element. The digital device which can able to store the data. Bolo.
RAM, sir.
RAM is there, ROM is there, pen drives is there, okay, SSDs are there, okay, so many devices are there. Now, tumi bolle RAM. So give me one specification of the RAM. Means just specification means based on the size. Just mention one size of the RAM.
8 GB.
8 GB. Okay, so that means 8 GB is there. Okay, GB means what?
Gigabyte, sir.
Gigabyte. Okay, so 8 means the gigabyte. So come to the byte. Byte means what? How many bits are there inside one byte?
8.
So 8 × 8 gigabits are there. Okay, so 64 gigabits are there. So you see, so many bits are there, and flip flop is the responsible device, or no, not the device, the module, which is responsible for storing one bit of information. So you need, in case of 8 GB RAM, how many flip flops are there? You can imagine. I think 64 giga. Okay, just do the calculation. You can find out that within this memory, how many flip flops are there? Because flip-flop is the device, not the device or whatever you call. Flip-flop is a digital circuit which can able to store one bit of information only, either a 0 or a 1. And in case of 8 GB RAM, you imagine how many flip-flops are there. Got this one? So that's why registers are not, sorry, the flip-flops are not combined to form the register from the memory element. Rather, few registers are there which can be combined and to form a memory element, which is called the register. Register is actually able to hold the binary information, because for storing either one bit of information doesn't means anything, because no computers are there where only one flip-flops are used to store only one bit of data. Here lots of data need to be stored. In case of RAM, in case of hard disk, in case of pen drive, we need to store lots of data. And for storing lots of data, lots of register, lots of flip-flops are there. Rather, just make a group of the register flip-flop and name it a register. So that means inside our memory element, so many registers also there. Register is nothing but the arrays or the group of the flip-flops. So this is called a register. So register is a group or binary storage cell. So another name is there, the binary storage cell. Okay, so binary storage cell is nothing but the flip-flop. Why it is called binary storage cell? Because this binary is means either 0 or 1. Binary means two value, either 0 or 1. So flip-flop is able to store either 0 or 1. That's why they are called, they are not called the memory element. They are called the storage cell. Okay. So this flip-flop is the binary storage cell, suitable for holding the binary information. Binary information means what? Information means a group of bits. Okay, say 10100000111, like this one. So a group of bits is called the binary information. So a group of flip-flops constitute a register. Since each flip-flop is a binary cell capable of storing one bit of information, a n-bit register has a group of n flip-flop and is capable of storing any in binary information containing n bit. The last sentence is only important here. That means n bit register. What is the meaning of the n bit register? So 5 bit register means what? What is the meaning of 5 bit register? Bolo, JK, what is the meaning of the 5 bit register? Very good. Correct answer. Pasta flip flop to definitely thakbe, 5 bit means. But in case, just respect to the storage device, what is the bit capability? What is the storage capability of this 5 bit register?
Sir, 5 bit binary number, sir.
Very good. So based on this memory capabilities, the 5 bit register can be able to hold or store 5 bit information. Okay, anything 10101, this is a 5 bit information. So this 5 bit information can be able to store inside this 5 bit register. So that means a n bit register in general has a group of n flip flops and capable of storing binary information containing n bit. তাহলে বোঝা গেল দ শর্ট কোশ্চেন মে কাম দ ডেটা নাও কামিং টু দিস ওয়ান হোয়াট আর দ্য টাইপ অফ দ্য রেজিস্টার ওকে সো ইন দ্য ফার্স্ট প্যারাগ্রাফ দ্য ডেফিনেশন অফ দ্য রেজিস্টার্স আর দেয়ার অ্যান্ড দ্য স্পেসিফিকেশন অফ দ্য রেজিস্টার সো 64 বিট রেজিস্টার মিনস আর রেজিস্টার হুইচ ক্যান এবল টু স্টোর দ্য 64 বিট অফ ইনফরমেশন অর 64 বিট অফ ওয়ান আর জিরো ওয়ান আর জিরো কম্বিনেশন অফ দিস ওয়ান নাও ইন দ্য নেক্সট This is the specific, not the specification, the classif, the types of the register. How many types are there? The classification of the types based on this input. So based on the data, how the data are entered inside the register and how the data are retrieved from the register, they are classified. Okay. So this is a register. Suppose n bit register, that means this register has n flip flop inside this one. Flip flop may be anything because all the flip flop are able to store the data. D flip flop, T flip flop, JK flip flop, SR flip flop, whatever be the flip flops are there, all are able to store the data. But one limitation is there. If you use the SR flip flop, the 1-1 condition should not be there. We have to design a circuit so that this condition will never come in case of SR flip flop. But every flip flop are able to store the data. So any type of flip-flop may be present inside the register. It's not an important thing. Important thing is that inside a register, how the data are stored inside the register and how the data are retrieved from the register. Based on this one, the registers are classified and they are called CISO, CIPO, PISO and PIPO. Now, what is the meaning of this one? 1 minute, please. CISO, CIPO, PISO, and PIPO means in case of CISO, serial in, serial out. So only one line will be there. And through the line, serially, the datas are entered inside the register. And in one, only output lines will be there. And through the output line, the datas are retrieved one by one. Suppose for a 5-bit register, if I want to store 10101, then first you need to store 1, then 0, then 1, then 0, then 1. So serially, one by one, using the help of 5 clock pulse, we can store the 5-bit data inside the register. Similarly, for retrieve the data from the register, 5-bit register, again, we need 5 clock pulse. First clock pulse, the last bit will go on next last bit like this one. So this is called the serial in, serial out. Now, give me the answer of this question. The objective may come from this one. For a 10-bit register, how many clock pulse, total clock pulse are required for storing and retrieving all the data?
10
bit register, how many total clock pulse are required for storing and retrieving all the data?
The 10 clock pulse are required.
The 10 clock pulse are
required. Wrong. Storing and retrieving also.
Then 20.
20 is the correct answer. So for storing 10 bit data, 10 clock pulse are required, and for retrieving or read from the register, again another 10 clock pulse are required. So total 20 clock pulse are required for storing the data inside the register and retrieving the data from the register also. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now tell me, for 20 bit register, if the CISO configuration was there, SISO, then how many output lines are there?
কি বললেন স্যার আবার বলুন
25 bit register, okay?
Yes, sir.
Configure is CISO, SISO. How many output lines are there?
25, sir.
Again wrong.
Sir, one.
Very good, one.
Oh, sorry, sir. One. Yes, sir. One.
CISO means single, sorry, it's not the single, serial in, serial out. So serial out means only one output line is there. Through the output line, serially, one by one, the data can be retrieved. Okay. Come to the another one, the second one, it's equal to SIPO, means serial in, parallel out. So in case of serial in, parallel out means for the 5-bit register, only one single input is there, but 5 parallel outputs are there. Okay. The data can be stored inside the register serially one by one, but the data can be retrieved from the register parallelly, means with the help of only one clock pulse. Okay. Bojha geche? What is called the SIPO?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, jodi bojha giye thakle answer dao. 10-bit register configuration is SIPO, S-I-P-O. 10-bit register configuration SIPO. How many total clock pulse are required for storing the data and retrieving the data?
11 clock pulse.
Very good. Correct answer. 11 clock pulse are required, because 10 clock pulse are required for storing 10-bit data one by one, and only one clock pulse is required for retrieving all the data parallelly. Very good. Last one, sorry, second last one is PISO. PISO means parallel in, serial out. Same. Parallelly, all the data are stored inside the register parallelly with the help of only one clock pulse, but the data can be retrieved from the register serially, one by one. And last one is PIPO, P-I-P-O. Here, parallel data input, parallel data output. Now, from your generals, means, ki bolo take, general, na, ki jano, common sense. So, from your common sense, just give me the answer of this question. Which one is the fastest register?
PIPO.
Very good, correct answer. And which one is the slowest register?
CISO.
Very good. But according to our application, according to our requirement, we have to sometime use the CISO, we have to use the PIPO. But otherwise, we may think that why we use a slow flip-flop? We need a very fast processor every time, fast data processing time, data transmission time. So that means PIPO is the most suitable register. But no, sometimes depending upon the condition, if you want to go for the computer architecture, then you see some conditions are there, some situations are there, where serially you need to send the data one by one. That's why the CISO is plays a parallel importance according to the PIPO also. Okay. So this is a 3-bit register using the D flip-flop. Here you see, it's a very simple, but this is the last topic, just to explain this circuit. After that, we deserve the class. So don't go for this one. It will take your time. That is the main problem in the digital electronics. If you just go like the circuit which is present everywhere in the internet, in the books, in my notes, then it will take a long time to understand what is the meaning of this circuit and how the circuit works. But if you see the animations in the circuit maker software, instantly you will understand what is the meaning of the circuit and how it is called a register. So that's why go for the register. So in
सर सोने ही अच्छा नहीं है।
তোরা স্যারের কথা শুনতে পাচ্ছিস? কেউ
না না শোনা যাচ্ছে না।
আবার বেরিয়ে গেছিলাম, এক মিনিট প্লিজ। এখন শুনতে পাচ্ছিস?
সার্কিট
মেকার ফাইল উই হ্যাভ, বাট হিয়ার দ্য ডিফারেন্স ইজ দ্যাট ইন দ্য পিপিটি I showed you a 3-bit register because that space is short here. Otherwise, the circuit is jumbled up. But in the circuit maker, just extend some of the segments, another two segments, another two flip flop to make it a 5-bit. Otherwise, both the things are exactly same. Okay, this is an example of 3-bit register, but this is the simulation of the 5-bit register. If we just delete this thing, it become a 3-bit. Now here we see, this is the D flip flop, which is readily available in the circuit maker as well as in the market. This is the active low preset and clear, means if you set the values, you just need to give a 0, then it will set like this one. So circuit in the run condition, you see the clock pulse is manual clock pulse, so clock pulse is not connected. The flip flop is disabled, you can say disabled, but as the preset and clear input has more priority compared to the flip flop. So if you want to set the flip flop, just give a clock pulse, you see instantly all the flip flop output become, this is nothing but the output, this LED is connected to the output of the flip flop, it becomes set. So that means this is called the preset. Before you apply the clock pulse, if you want to set everything, it just give a 0 here, active whatever be the input, active low in this case, it will set the flip flop. Got it?
Yes, sir.
And if you want to clear this thing, just give a clear pulse, it will clear. But remember this thing, preset and clear should not be connected to 0 and 0 permanently. After clearing all these things, again you need to connect it to the normal mode, that is 1 here. Otherwise, the circuit will not run. Okay, now you see this is the output and this is the input. So here you see this one is the parallel in parallel out register. Example of the parallel in parallel out register. How many bits are there? How many bit register it is?
5 bit.
Very good. Just count the flip flop. If the flip flop number is n, this is the n bit register. Now somebody please tell me 5-bit data. Any 5-bit data?
Sir, 10101.
Achha, 10101. 10101 to achai dekhi. Onno kichu bol ekta.
11011.
11011. So first I need to give the data according to the data which you want to store, or the data may come from any different parts of our computer or a motherboard. Then what we need to do, we just need to give a clock pulse. So here you see, I just give a clock pulse, and on the occurrence of the clock pulse, these data are stored inside the flip-flop, because this is the reflection of the what the data stored inside this particular flip-flop. So you see 11011, this is the parallel in parallel out. The data are stored parallelly. Here we doesn't need to give the separate clock pulse, 5 clock pulse for storing the data. Whatever be the data you want to store, suppose the 10101, so 10101. So first we need to set the data to the input of the flip flop, D flip flop, then just give a clock pulse. On the occurrence of the clock pulse, the data which was present at the input of the flip flop instantly stored inside the flip flop. Because D flip flop is nothing but the data flip flop, it actually does follow whatever is the input. As the D input, it will produce the output. So in this way, the flip flop works. Or this is the register work, rather the register works. So register is a combination of flip flop. So here you see the 5-bit register, and this is the PPO configuration, parallel in, parallel out. So whatever be the data you want to store, you need to give the data is the according to the input of the flip flops and give the clock pulse. On the occurrence of the clock pulse, the data instantly stored inside the flip flop. Got this one?
Yes, sir.
So as long as the data are constant in the input, then whatever be the clock pulse you apply, the data will not change. Because it is, the input is not changed, that's why it changed the output. But if you change the input, then you see it will reflect the output. Now it is 11101. So this is called the register. So this register is the nothing but the memory element in our computer. Whatever be the memory you know right now, all this memory are nothing but the combination of this register. Only the size is big, that is the 5-bit only. So just increase the size. So VLSI is there, very large scale integration. So what is the meaning of this VLSI? That is the electronic subject. So VLSI, very large scale integration, means inside one IC, how to insert million number of transistor, or you can say million number of component. So this is one of the component, the flip flop is one of the component. So how to insert million number of component inside a particular silicon chip, this technique is called the VLSI. VLSI will not modify the circuit. You are the engineers. As a design engineer, you need to design everything in a simulation software like the circuit maker basic, and so many higher PSPICE is there, so many higher circuit means higher version of this circuit simulation software is there. This is your responsibility to design the circuit. Once you design the circuit, VLSI is only one technique how to insert this circuit in a tiny chip. So that that particular procedure is the fall in the VLSI chapter. But VLSI will not design anything. Okay, আমরা সবাই বলি আর VLSI শিখবো, VLSI শিখবো, VLSI কিচ্ছু জানার দরকার নেই. VLSI is the process how to insert million number of chips inside a million number of component inside a silicon chip. Okay, that is called the VLSI. Like you see the packaging, now the packaging is becoming engineering also. So once you buy some mobile from the Flipkart or any other online site, you see the packaging is so small. Sometimes you wonder that inside this packet the mobile is there or not, because some when the delivery or the wish maker give me the packet, I see the size of the packet is very small. So I wonder that my mobile is there inside this one, but when I open this one, I see my mobile is there, charger is there, data cable is there, SIM ejector pin is there, some useless document is also there. So that means this is the technology how to insert so many things in a very much complicated packet. Okay. In a very good manner, so that everything is there, but the size becomes small. That is the technique in packaging, and in case of manufacturing, it is called the VLSI. Got this one?
Yes, sir.
So this is the example of the 3-bit or 5-bit register, parallel in, parallel out register. Next day, আমরা কি করবো? আসলে next day কি করবো? Next day তে জানা যাবে. So next day তে we will understand this. Another type of register is there. Should naam gulo shuna nao. Shift register. Okay, shift register means one. How many avail the Shialdah station or the Howrah station? Everybody, I think, or everybody see the scrolling display inside the government bus, because nowadays this government bus ki junum na ki lekha thake na ekta. So you see one of the scrolling display was there, and in this scrolling display it is the number, the name of the number of the bus, the destination, the middle stop, everything is scrolled down. So is the letter changing? No, letters are constant. Suppose bus number is 235, so this 235 is constant, but the position is constantly changing. So this is done by the shift register. So in case of shift register, it will not modify the data, but it will responsible for shifting the data either from the left side to right side or from the right side to left side according to the requirement. And the register which has the property to shift its data in both the direction, left or right, it is called the bi-directional register. Got it?
Yes, sir.
So next day we'll learn the shift register, left shift or right shift, and the bidirectional register, and at last the register which has the four possible input output mode, means CISO, CPO, PPO, PISO, and the bidirectional property is called the universal register. So in your syllabus also the definition of the universal syllabus is also there, and some of the IC number is also there in the markout syllabus. Question never came that what is the, now sometime I think came a stupid question, because the engineer, why the engineer should remember the name of the IC? The data sheets are the internets are there, memory elements are there, why you need to remember anything? We are the designer, we can apply our knowledge to design something, why should we remember something? Okay, এটা আবার ভুল ভেবো না, আমাদের ফিজিক্সে আমরা ল কেন বলবো? হ্যাঁ, বিকজ দিস থিং ইজ রিকোয়ার্ড, বাট দ্য নেম অফ দ্য আইসি, দ্য রিমেম্বারিং দ্য নেম অফ দ্য আইসি ইজ নট রিকোয়ার্ড। সো দিস আর দ্য আইসি, দিস আর দ্য আইসি হুইচ হ্যাজ দ্য ইউনিভার্সাল রেজিস্টার, দিস ইজ দ্য 4-bit ইউনিভার্সাল রেজিস্টার, দ্য 74198 ইজ দ্য 8-bit ইউনিভার্সাল রেজিস্টার, দিস আর দ্য বেসিক, দিস আর অবসোলেটেড 50 ইয়ার্স ব্যাক, নেভার ইউজড নাওয়েডেজ, বাট নাওয়েডেজ 64-bit রেজিস্টার্স আর দেয়ার, 128-bit registers are also there, but the same thing, only the VLSI technique, the component is more, but the technology remains same. Okay, what the engineer developed in 50 years back, the same thing is actually implemented, and some modification is obviously there. Eglo amra next day the porbo. Okay, so thank you very much for attending the class. You people are really good, because some other teacher complaining against you, but I never face any problem with you in my class. তোমরা কি অন্য কোনো ক্লাসে কিছু কমেন্ট ফরমেন্ট করেছিলে নাকি?
না না স্যার, কমেন্ট তো কোনো ক্লাসেই করা হয় না।
তো আমি বুঝি আমার কাছে তো
কিসের কমেন্ট বুঝতে পারলাম না,
কেমন কমেন্ট?
তোকে আমি খুলে বলবো কিসের কমেন্ট? তুই যদি আমাকে ভালো কোনো কোশ্চেন করিস এটাকে কি কমেন্ট বলে?
না না স্যার, কি টোন? না না স্যার, আমাদের কোনো স্টুডেন্ট এরকম কিছু করেনি কোনো ক্লাসে।
না স্যার, আমাদের কেউ চলে
গেছে। আমি তো জানি, আমাকে বলেছিল যে এরকম কিছু একটা হয়েছে, বাট আমি বললাম আমার ক্লাসে তো কোনোদিন কিছু,
আমাদের স্যার স্টুডেন্টরা কেউ কেউ ক্লাস করে না এরকম আছে, বাট কেউ এরকম কমেন্ট করে না।
কমেন্ট আমাদের ক্লাসে কেউ করে না স্যার।
কি হয়েছে কে জানে, কমেন্ট না কোনো একটা তর্কাতর্কি হয়তো হয়েছে কিছু, হয়তো জানি না, আমি কিছু নাম বলছি না কারো, কিন্তু আমি বললাম আমার ক্লাসে তো কোনোদিন কোনো একটা অসুবিধা হয়নি, দেখা যাক। ওকে, সো